one of the very famous theory of psychology, that is the psychodynamic theory. Now, what is the psychodynamic theory? Hello everyone, today we'll be discussing about one of the very famous theory of psychology, that is the psychodynamic theory. Now, what is the psychodynamic theory? So, we all are living in this world where we keep on dealing with a lot of stressful situations. Now, how are you going to deal with those stressful situations? This is one of the theory that is going to help you to deal with those stressful situations. Now, this becomes very important for your psychology optional in UPSC. So let's begin. Now, what is the psychodynamic theory? So psychodynamic theory is a theory which actually helps you in dealing with the stressful situation. Now, when you encounter any of the, you know, stressful situation in your day-to-day life or anytime, now, how are you going to cope with it? How are you going to grow out of it? So that's what psychodynamic theory is. Now, this theory tells you about coping with the stressful situation. It tells you how to grow out of it. It tells you how to develop your inner self. That means there are some people who say that they got more stronger after they encountered this difficulty in their life. Why are they why are they saying so? So they are saying so because they developed their inner self and then change. So change as in what? Now this change is more pertaining to the fact that you change your behavior. Now what happens out of this? See, this theory was actually given by Sigmund Freud. And this theory is usually referred as a clinically derived theory. Now, why clinically derived theory? For a very simple reason, because whatever he experienced or whatever he is going to tell you about psychodynamic theory is purely based on the fact that he has been referring all these facts through his patients. So that is why this theory is referred as a clinically derived theory. So clinically derived theory, because most of his theories or most of the part of this theory is derived from the patients that he has been using or that he has been working his therapy on. Now, apart from this, what Sigmund Freud has talked about psychodynamic theory? So, Freud's theory of personality. Now, this Freud's theory of personality comprises of three components. What are those three components? First is your ID, second is ego, and third is superego. Now, the figure represents the three human aspects. Like, what are those aspects? The first ID says that I want it now. Now, this is a kind of desire. A desire to have something. Second is ego, which says that I need to do a bit of planning to get it. So you can say this is talking about rationality. And the third component of Freud's theory of personality is talking about you can't have it, it's not right. So what you can say is that superego is talking about ethical and moral perspectives. Now let's talk about it. See, the ID talks about what? That there is an inner desire for something. Now, when there is an inner desire for something, what's happening is that you want it. So the next pack goes to ego. Now, the next component of this theory talks about what ego, which says that you need a bit of planning. So this is about rationality. When the third comes, so they say or they refer, that is the super ego refers to what? The ethical and the moral aspect of it. Now, if you could visualize, then you will always find that a person or the self or for that matter, you, me or anyone will always have this conflict in their mind. Conflict as in what? So this conflict perspective shall always exist in the self. And what is that conflict perspective? Now see, there is a desire and then there is moral and ethical perspective. So there shall always be a conflict between ID and super ego. So conflict perspective in self between ID and super ego. Now, when this stage arises, how is the self going to act or how is the self going to behave? Because, you know, we encounter this every time. Why? Because we have a certain desire to have something. And at the same time, somewhere or other, our superego knows that, okay, this might not be good for us. Okay, it might be good for us, but ethically, this is not correct. So if you know this, that this is ethically not correct, how are you going to go about it? So one thing which is very evident from here is that if there is a conflict between ID and superego, you know, how are we going to make peace with it? So here comes the ego, which will try to neutralize things. Right? So this is Freud's theory of personality, which says that first there shall be a desire, and this desire is considered with ID. Then second is your ego, which shall talk about rationality. And third is your superego. And this superego is talking about what? The moral and ethical aspects of the things. Now, this moral and ethical aspect will always deal with what is right and what is wrong. So there are situations or there are times where we land up in dilemma, like what or what is right, or you know, whether this will be right or not, whether this will be going to give correct results or not. So that is a situation where conflict arises between ID and superego, and to resolve that, ego tries to neutralize them, or you can say ego tries to balance them out. Fine. So this is from where the beginning happens. Now, moving on to the other aspects of psychodynamic theory. Okay. So the point is, what is the goal of psychodynamic theory? That means if we are having this psychodynamic theory, what is the goal of such theory? So the goal of such theory shall always deal with what? That means you should firstly acknowledge your emotions. That means we should read our emotions. We should know what actually why we are behaving in that manner. That means, firstly, why is this emotion getting generated? So we need to acknowledge that emotion. For example, if we are sad, then why this emotion, why this emotion got generated? So we need to acknowledge that emotion. Once we have acknowledged that emotion, we need to study the pattern. That means how often we are going through this pattern, or how often we are behaving in this manner. And similarly, what is going to happen is, from here onwards, we'll know why our behavior is, or why our relationships are changing. Now, once you know that why your relationships are changing, and why this pattern is occurring, then what will happen is, from here onwards, if you start working on this emotion, on this pattern, what will happen ultimately is your improvement in relationships could be witnessed. Fine. Okay. Now the point is that you have acknowledged the emotion, you have studied the pattern, you have addressed the behavior or the changes in your relationship. Now your relationship got improved, and this is what is the goal of psychodynamic theory. Now, the second part says that assumptions of psychodynamic theory. Now, what are the assumptions of psychodynamic theory? Now, the assumption of the psychodynamic theory starts from the fact that, all behaviors of humans, for that matter, are always connected with emotions. That means our behavior Our behaviors are underlying cause of everything. That means if we behave properly, everything is going to get on track. So that's what psychodynamic theory says, that behaviors are underlying cause of all. Now, other than that, what psychodynamic theory says is that an adult's behavior, that means you must somewhere or other you would have definitely gone through this aspect, that some people say that, okay, this person is behaving in this manner, why? Because he has encountered this while during his childhood, or while he was a child, or the reason why he is behaving in this manner is because this is what he experienced in his childhood. So the assumption of psychodynamic theory also says this, that the adult's behavior is because of their childhood experience. So we can say that somewhere or other the psychodynamic theory is talking about, or is trying to say, that adult's personality is equal to what? Firstly, the inner thing, what he or she is perceiving. That means the experiences that they have, they have encountered, and finally they have perceived. So the internal processes and the external world, or the external environment. So, you know, both of them contribute towards what? Development of an adult's personality. So, if a person is aggressive or if a person is very kind, what we can say is that the behavior or the nature of the person is because of what two processes. One is your internal process, that's something that you have perceived, and the second one is your external environment that you have been living in. Fine. Now let's move on to the next aspect. What is the next aspect? The next aspect is talking about evolution of psychodynamic theory. That means, how come the evolution of psychodynamic theory happened? That means what led to this evolution? That means, what are those factors that actually said that, these are probably the reasons because of which the human psychology is affected, or you can say the human psychology could be studied. So the first theory says drive theory. Now, what is drive theory? Now, this is, I have discussed in the previous slides also, that means a person's behavior is driven by a lot many facts. And what are those facts? For example, say aggression. Perseverance, etc. So what is happening is that under drive theory, that means what drives a person's behavior, what has led to that situation. The first thing is person's behavior. Now, person's behavior is talking about what? That means the person's behavior is result of many things. For example, it could be, the experiences, it could be anything. So, person's behavior and this person's behavior, you can say it becomes the personality of the person. Now, the second one is ego psychology. Now, what is ego psychology? Now, the ego psychology talks about the person's environment, or you can say person's reality, which is leading to a person's ego. That means there is a person's environment in which the person is born and brought up. So the environment in which the person is born and brought up, this is leading to what? A buildup of person's ego. And this becomes a part of a person's personality. Fine. Now, third is object relation theory. Now, object relation theory, this could be understood through an example. For example, when I told you that, some say that the person's personality is because of whatever he or she has experienced in their childhood. So, similarly, in object relation theory, what is going to happen is that this psychodynamic theory says that if an adult has faced something, say, in childhood, so what they are going to do is that they are going to do the similar thing. That means the act is going to be repetitive. Once they have faced it, other time they are going to do it with the other person, or you can say with the other one. For example, that child faced the trauma and now the child is grown up. And once the child is grown up, he or she is an adult. Now, when they are adult, what is going to happen is they are going to do the similar thing to, you can say, the child only. So that is what is object relation theory. Now, that object relation theory is talking about what? Now, the object relation theory is about repeating the learned experience. Fine. Okay. The next one is self-psychology. Now, what is self-psychology? So, self-psychology says that it is a way of perception. That means the person having the perception of themselves. So, perception of themselves. Is what is called self-psychology. Fine. Now, see, whatever we have studied over here, and whatever this is just a brief aspect of psychodynamic theory. Whatever we have just gone through. Now, there are some people who have been criticizing this psychodynamic theory. Now, they are criticizing it to a fact. They are saying that, the Freud's theory of the psychodynamic. Now, Freud's theory talked about ID, ego and superego. So, some psychologists are of the opinion that we cannot apply this psychodynamic theory universally for a reason. Because if you talk about ego, then... the psychologists say that in some sense, this theory becomes very sexist. Now, why this theory becomes sexist? Because they say that men tend to have, So they say that men tend to have more ego as compared to women. And in that way, this psychodynamic theory fails. So, this is the opinion of certain psychologists. Now, the other thing or the other criticism that is coming is that in this theory is very deterministic. Deterministic as in what aspect? Deterministic as in this aspect that they consider this theory as a victim-blaming theory. That means you kind of are victimizing yourself or the person or the object. So they consider it to be a victim-blaming theory. They consider it to be very deterministic. They consider it to be very sexist because they say that some or other men tend to have more ego as compared to the women section. Right? Now, other than this, certain psychologists are of the opinion also that if you go through the entire theory, you will find that we are trying to find solution of everything. That means if you are stressful, probably how to get rid of that stress, how to cope up with that, how to grow out of it, how to develop out of it. So how is this even possible? So this is not a psychodynamic theory, rather it's a psychotreatment theory. So they say that instead of saying that it's a psychodynamic theory, we should actually say it's a psycho treatment theory. Fine. So this is what can be concluded from the psychodynamic theory, but this I would say is a criticism aspect that is coming from various psychologists. So this is what is about psychodynamic theory. Thank you so much.